Hello, I'm Barney, your senior network engineer from Zyxel Networks. Welcome to our Tech Talk. Here we will discuss the different kinds of solutions supported by your Zyxel products that can improve network performance and services. In this video, we will be focusing on the top three reasons for switch stacking. Stacking is a unique switch technology. Switch stacking, or hardware stacking, transforms multiple switch hardware into a single virtual switch to gain advantages over its management, maintenance, and even allows you to implement redundancies that wouldn't be possible with normal Ethernet switch deployments. Let's start by discussing the main limitations of our standard switch deployments. An enterprise network refers to the IT infrastructure of an organization. We call an enterprise network large by the number of clients or devices connecting to it. It comes to reason that these larger enterprise networks use high-end switch hardware as the backbone for their IP network architecture. While switches in the access layer provides basic entry for end devices to access the internal network, switches in the backbone interconnects all access switches with the inner network. However, not all hardware are meant to last forever. Your network equipment may eventually break down due to material degradation or even shut down due to random electrical failures. So let's say that one of our backbone switch suddenly fails. A single backbone switch going offline would cause any clients connected under this unit to lose access to the inner network. Because of this, network administrators must pay close attention to avoid single points of failure, especially in their network backbone. And this is where switch stacking comes in. Switch stacking is an innovative technology that turns multiple physical switch units into a single virtual switch. This is done by utilizing dedicated switch ports for integrating additional switch units into the switch stack. Converting your switch units into a switch stack provides network administration with three unique benefits. First off, switch stacking combines the management of your switch hardware under a single pane of glass. Network administrators may simply access the web GUI of the main switch stack to monitor and configure all switch units in that same switch stack. Most administrators manage our devices by accessing the device web GUI using your common internet browser. Without stacking, the network administrator will need to enter the IP address of each device, enter the login name and password, and then start applying your network settings on different pages of each switch units. Compare this with stacking. The administrator only needs to enter a single IP address to access the entire switch stack. Each switch unit in the stack is referred to a slot. We can then identify each ports on the stack by a combination of their slot and port number. A switch in stacking mode will have their web GUI transformed. Each pages with port-related settings gives the administrator options to switch between different slots. You will also notice that the UI clearly shows the slot and port number. This usefulness of a single pane of glass management also extends to how you can update your switch's software version. Administrators may access the firmware upgrade page from the web GUI of the switch stack alone. From there, make sure to select the All option to initiate an identical firmware upgrade process on all four stack members. In short, stacking saves you time and effort with managing your network devices. Another unique benefit to stacking is how it expands your network bandwidth while allowing the implementation of a more reliable traffic redundancy. When we talk about bandwidth and redundancy, the most common solution that comes to mind is link aggregation. Link aggregation combines multiple links between two devices to potentially increase the network bandwidth by load sharing traffic between these links. Not only that, it also offers traffic redundancies in case one of the aggregated links go down. However, conventional link aggregation has a main drawback. This technology requires that the aggregated links to be connected to a single physical unit. This means that link aggregation is stuck only providing link redundancy. Should the entire switch stack go offline, traffic will not be able to pass through no matter how many links you aggregate. We can prove how ineffective this type of implementation is by simulating how traffic flows in this topology during specific link failures. Traffic from the clients flow to our typical access switch. The access switch then runs its algorithm to allocate which link to forward the client traffic. Assuming the access switch sends this traffic to the top link, the backbone switch above simply passes this to the next device. From here, everything seems to work fine. But what happens if a link failure occurs further away from the access switch? So let's simulate a link failure that occurs between the backbone switch and its uplink device. Traffic from the clients flows to our typical access switch. The access switch then delivers this traffic on either of its aggregated ports. From here, we can already see the problem. Should the access switch pass the traffic to the bottom switch, then everything should be fine. However, should the access switch pass the traffic to the top switch, instead, the client traffic may never reach its destination. So the main reason why we can't just link these aggregated ports between separate devices is because they are operating as a separate system. This is where stacking comes in. By turning these hardware into a single virtual switch, we allow the switch system to recognize and react to link failures within stack members as if it was a single unit. So whether this is a link failure or if an entire unit shuts down, the switch stack effectively distributes traffic to any of its remaining active links. Best of all, link aggregation is a pretty standard technology that is supported by a wide range of network devices. These are your gateways or routers, servers, and other access switches. Another unique benefit to using switch stacking is how easy it is for administrators to accommodate the growth of your enterprise network. Normally, you just need to access the web GUI of a Zyxel switch and enable stacking mode. Once enabled, administrators can simply connect the stacking port of the new switch together with the switch stack. After rebooting, the switch now becomes a part of the switch stack. Companies can start deploying 2 to 3 switch units in the first few years after its inception. As the company grows and more employees join the workforce, the network administrator can simply add more switch units into the switch stack. Note that a switch stack may only allow switches of the same series to join the stack. For instance, you can combine a Zyxel XGS2210-28 Ethernet switch with an XGS2210-52 HP Ethernet switch. This is because these two models belong under the same switch series. However, you can't create a switch stack with an XS3800-28 Ethernet switch with this existing stack since the XS3800 is under a different switch series. Links are in the description if you want to know which Zyxel Ethernet switches support stacking. Well, that's it for today's Tech Talk. Hope this video can help you understand how to use our Zyxel network solution. Like, comment, and subscribe, and I hope to see you in our next Tech Talk. Bye-bye.
We're Zyxel, and we're your networking ally.